We have to do a 3-minute, 3-slide presentation. So we could only use, including the title slide, we can only use a maximum of 3 slides, and we could not go over 3 minutes.
It doesn't have to be specifically about cancer biology, but it could be related to. But I think that the most important thing that he wants us to get out of this exercise is to not only be comfortable speaking to other people, but to stay within the 3-minute range.
You're always on the clock when presenting. You never want to go longer than you have to, because then your audience starts to get bored. That's basically what Dr. Francia wanted us to learn, how to speak in public.
It was a little bit of a challenge to make a technical topic and make it into something that would be simpler, that my classmates would understand, and then explain how it works, a little bit of its background in only 3 minutes and 3 slides. So it was a little bit of a challenge.
It's so complex, you have to find a way to make it easy for everybody to understand. So you have to understand the subject very well, because if you don't know how to explain it in a simple way, then it means that you don't understand it.
I dreaded those things.
I think it took me about like 2 presentations to really get the hang of it. But it really did give us like positive feedback though, because as soon as we presented, students were able to give their own opinion about what should have been changed, what could have we done to improve our presentations, the way we deliver the message. It was actually very useful, actually.
I think it's a good idea because it gets everybody really comfortable like speaking publicly, and I like that we have really short presentations, because a lot of other instructors, they make you give like either like a 15-minute presentation or like an hour-long presentation. And I think I really prefer the 3-minute ones. Not only is it shorter, it's, I think, well, it helps us as students, like condense, like I've said before, like condense information and make sure that the public only gets the most important things out of it.
So I think that as for undergrads, it's a very good experience. So when, if they do decide to go to grad school, or just if they're in any situation where they have to present to a large number of people, it prepares them in some sort of way, and it helps them see their own weaknesses so that they can improve in the future.
It's good practice. It's an opportunity to get feedback, which is what we need.